This video is sponsored by Hostinger. Hey, what's up, you guys, and welcome back to Gal. So in a lot of the videos that I do for this channel, I use a screen recorder to show you what I'm doing on my computer when I'm doing a particular tutorial or effect. And a lot of you guys have reached out to me asking what screen recording software I use to produce high quality screen recording and some editing tips to make it smooth. So that's what I'm going to do in this video. I'm going to break down free options as well as paid for options for both Mac and PC, and then dive into Premiere Pro to give you some tips that I use to make those screen recordings feel very smooth as if there's no edits done at all. So for the first option for Mac for free is QuickTime Player, which comes built in on a Mac computer. So the first step is to open up the QuickTime Player. Then from the file menu, select New Screen Recording. And here this will bring you a little widget from which you can choose which type of microphone that you want to use. I'm using the Rode NT USB mic. And if you want to show the mouse clicks, and I want the mouse clicks to be shown, especially for instructional style screen recordings. And then here you can see a reading of how much audio is getting picked up. Now, another way to see how sensitive your microphone is, if you go up to the sound settings and you open up sound preferences on your computer, you can go to input and then you can select your microphone and then you can choose your input volume. So as you see, if I bring it all the way up, it's super loud. So the center is good because you can always add some sound correction inside of your editing application. In Premiere Pro, the Essential Sound Panel does just that. So once that's ready to go, you're just going to click the record button and then you can click to record the full screen or you can drag to record part of the screen. So I'm just going to click and then I'll just record a few seconds here of just my background desktop screensaver here. And then I'm going to go up and just hit the stop button to stop the recording. And then it will show you a preview of what the screen recording looked like. So you can see it's just the background here. What you can do from here is go up to File and you can export as 4K, 1080p, 720, 480, or even audio only. I would recommend doing 4K because then you can have more resolution to work with. So I'll just save this as test and I will hit save and it's going to export this test.mov to my desktop. Now I've used QuickTime for a lot of screen recordings when I first started out my channel, but as I started doing more longer screen recordings, I noticed sometimes QuickTime Player would freeze if I was doing a screen recording longer than 25 to 30 minutes. And so that would just be more work for me. And sometimes it would cut off my audio at random parts. So it's definitely a great screen recorder considering it's completely free and built in. So to get started, I would highly recommend using QuickTime Player. And then the paid for option for Mac is Capto. So I have Capto open right here. You can see I have a ton of screen recordings here because I use this for basically every video on my channel. And to create a new screen recording, all you do is click up here on record and you can record the entire screen or you can select an area. So after you select screen, what happens is it gives you these different options. Now, my favorite option here is the record computer audio. Now, if you have this checked, this is super great if you are demonstrating something and you want this screen recorder to actually record what your computer is playing back. So if you're playing back something in Premiere Pro or you're playing a YouTube video or something and you want to record the audio, just make sure that is checked. Now you're also going to want to make sure that you have your sound settings also set to Capto for Mac to make sure that it's going to point to Capto. And if you're inside of any type of software, you want to make sure you go to that software's audio settings and make sure it's the output of that is being set to Capto as well. And just like QuickTime Player, you can record the microphone here. I'm going to use the Rode NT USB, and I'm going to show the cursor during the recording and also highlight the mouse clicks. Since this video is sponsored by Hostinger, I'm going to screen record their website. To start, just hit record. Now I can go into Google Chrome and I'll just type in hostinger.com and make it full screen. So my voice is now recording and so is the screen. And later in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to zoom in and out to different areas of the screen to highlight certain areas, but for now, here's a little bit about Hostinger. It's a great web hosting platform with more than just hosting. There's also a domain checker and a website builder. So if I click on domain checker and I type in video production, it'll show all of the domains available that include that variation of the keywords. So I think videoproduction.space is a pretty cool domain if you run a studio, and it's only 99 cents per year. You can also use Hostinger to build your website using templates, and it comes with a free domain and hosting. So if you're interested in Hostinger, you can get 15% off with my code GAL using the link in my description. And now once we're done with the recording, you'll just go up here to this little Capto recording red button and just hit stop and save recording. And one thing I wanted to tell you about before we go into editing tips in Premiere Pro is there's this pretty cool feature inside of Capto that I haven't seen on any different type of screen recording. Is if you select open current URL in Capto, what this will do is it'll open up the current URL that you have open in Chrome, and you can actually download it as a PDF. So you know how if you want to print out something from a website, well, what you can do is just click this button, PDF Saver, and then you can call this whatever you like. I'm just gonna save it to the desktop. So I saved it to the desktop, and look at this. It's a full-on high-quality PDF. And if I double-click to open this up, or if I right-click and open it up with preview, you can see the high-quality PDF quality of this. And all I had to do was click one button. So I think that is a pretty cool tool, and I would highly recommend trying this out, especially if you're doing educational stuff. So I'm just going to exit this web bit. And then my favorite aspect of it all is if you select the screen recording, you can right click and you can send it to Adobe Premiere Pro, whichever version that you're using. And to add Adobe Premiere, you would just hit configure and you can add any app that you like. So I'm just going to select Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2019, and this should launch open Adobe Premiere Pro. So as this is opening up, two apps I want to recommend for PC users. If you guys are using a PC and you want a free option, I would recommend using OBS. I actually use OBS here on my Mac computer, and it provides a free option if you want to record a window. So here you can see I have the Hostinger Google Chrome open, and you would just start your recording. And it's a pretty cool tool to use. I haven't used it on a PC because I don't have a PC, but I've heard great things. Another paid option for PC users is Movavi. And this is a great tool. I haven't used it personally, but I've read about it and it seems like a great tool to use. So definitely check out Movavi, and I'll put the links to the PC options in the description box below. All right, so now Premiere Pro is open, and you can see here that this is the screen recording of Hostinger that I just recorded. Now I'm going to create a new sequence by going down here, selecting new item, new sequence, and I'm going to make a 1080p 30 frames per second sequence, hit OK, and now we have sequence one open here. Now I'm just going to drag and drop the screen recording down here into the sequence. And I'm going to keep existing settings, and you will see that it's actually quite big. And if you go into the settings here, which is pretty cool, if you go to list view, so if you go to the list view and then we scroll over to look at the video capture resolution, you can see it was actually captured in Ultra HD 4K, which is 3,840 pixels by 2,160. So that's great because that means we can scale and zoom in our 1080p HD timeline without losing resolution. So what I like to do first is right click on the clip in the sequence and scale it to frame size. So now it's perfectly inside of the frame. If you want to, you can select this and you can go to effect controls, and you can scale it up even more just to get rid of that top bar at the top. And you can move it over like so, just so it's more clean. Now, another tip that I want to give you guys is if you want to zoom into a particular portion to highlight something that's going on in the program monitor here. So as I scrub through and I go to domain checker, as I start to type something in, maybe I wanted to zoom in on this moment. So what I'm going to do is hit C for the razor tool, and I'm going to cut there and I'm gonna scrub forward to the moment I want it to cut. So I'm going to zoom in here, and then I'm going to scrub back to the moment where I want it to zoom back out. So now with this portion of the clip selected, I'm going to select this and I'm going to scale it in so we just see this bit here. And you can see there's a lot of resolution to work with, so it doesn't look super pixelated. Now, rather than keyframing to animate from this point to this point, I'm gonna use this transition and it's called Motion Tween. And I love Motion Tween. I've done an entire tutorial on it. It's by Film Impact. And it's super cool and it saves me so much time. All I need to do is drag Impact Motion Tween right here at this edit point. And you will see that it looks kind of funky right now, but that's because we need to select it, then go to Effect Controls and change the render option to composite. Now, if I just set an endpoint and an outpoint and hit return on my keyboard to render out just that little bit there, it'll render it out. And now if I play it back, you can see that it zooms in really nicely. So that's like a really cool tip to zoom in without having to worry about keyframing or anything like that. It's just a drag and drop. And then I can copy this. I can take this effect and select it and then Command C to copy it. Then over here at this edit point, Command V to paste it. And what that will do, if I render this out now, and now at this point, after it's done typing, it zooms back out. So that's a really cool tip that I definitely highly recommend using when you're doing screen recordings. Another cool thing is that you can actually use the Essential Graphics panel, what I like to call the EGP, to create like little callouts or circles or rectangles to call attention to certain things. So for example, if I right click here and I clear the in and out, and then let's say I wanted to highlight the domain checker here, I can go over here to the toolbar and I can select the rectangle tool. And here I can actually draw a rectangle around this area to highlight it. And then going over to the Essential Graphics panel here, the EGP, you're going to uncheck fill and then select stroke, and you can increase the stroke to like 15 or so. And then change this color to something that'll stand out, like a bright yellow color. And now you have a call out here. Now I also use an impact plugin because what's really cool is as you're playing this back, while it appears here, you can actually have the rectangle animate on screen. And I use this really cool plugin called Impact Pop, which is part of one of their transition packs. Now I know that these are paid for plugins, but trust me, I use them in almost every video and it's well worth it. It's only a one-time fee and it's amazing. So let me just type in Impact Pop. And all I do is just drag and drop this on here and it just pops up on screen. Just like that. It's pretty cool. And then I'll just drag and drop it at the end too. So you can easily create just quick little animations like that and an animation to pop off. It just gives it more of like a pro effect, which is definitely useful. So another tip is how to create a freeze frame if you need to hold on the screen a bit longer while you're talking. That's easily achievable. So this is a great example of doing a web screen recording. Sometimes you're talking and the website actually takes a second to load. So you can see it's like a white screen here and we just want to speed it up because we don't want to wait while this white screen is here for several seconds as it's loading. So what I can do is I can use the arrow keys to go forward until that white screen is there and then hit C on my keyboard to cut. And then you'll just scrub through until the white goes away and the page is loaded. So here you're just going to hit C again to cut and then hit V on your keyboard to go to the selection tool and then delete that bit there. Now what we're going to do is extend this shot here while I'm continuing to talk. So rather than doing a frame hold, I actually prefer to use this feature, which is called Export Frame. So I select that and then I import into project and I'll just call it still number one and hit OK. Then I go to the project panel and here is still number one. And I just drag and drop it down here to fill in this gap. So that way, as I continue to talk, you know, there's something on the screen and there's not like that white background happening. And you'll notice here that I actually am not talking here. I probably said there. So what I can do is hit C and just cut out this bit here just to speed it up. Because with screen recording, it's really about making it as precise as possible so you can get to the good stuff as quickly as possible. So that's it. The freeze frame, cutting out excess bits, the call outs here, plus the little animations and the motion tween zoom are pro tips to making your screen recording look awesome. So I hope that all of you guys found these screen recording and editing tips useful. If you guys have any questions, be sure to leave a comment below. And now a question for you guys. What screen recording software have you used that you might recommend? And if you guys need any further help or free templates, please join my Patreon community at patreon.com/premieregal. And I look forward to seeing you guys there. So that's it for this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.